So what is the mass? The mass is the mountaintop. When a mountain climber is headed up toward the peak, they often pass by clouds. They have this transcendent experience and come to a height where they see things in a whole new way. That's what the mass is. When God brought his people, the Israelites, out of slavery in Egypt, across the Red Sea, he gave them a special ritual called the Passover. It was a Passover supper that they would celebrate every year, and they would tell the story about how God brought them out of slavery, and they would have a symbolic meal as well that they would eat while they told the story. Well, Jesus, at a Passover supper, had the first mass. He took the bread and took the wine and transformed it into his own body and blood. And then he said to the apostles, "Do this in memory of me." And so what happens at mass now? Well, really, we continue to tell the story. You'll go to mass and you'll hear the scriptures. God speaks to you when you listen to the scriptures, you listen to the homily. And then we have the meal, the very body and blood of Jesus Christ. God feeds you. So we continue to listen to the story of our salvation and allow God to feed us on the food of salvation, the very body and blood of Jesus Christ, which he said in John chapter 6, "My flesh is true food, my blood is true drink." I like to think of the Mass also as going to God's house. You have a good conversation with God, and then you have a great meal with God, and you leave feeling full. And so with the Mass, the most amazing moment, the summit of the mountaintop, is when the body and blood of Jesus become truly present at the altar. When the priest, who's given that sacred power by the sacrament of holy orders, says, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body." And I've said it before, and I must say it again, that that's my favorite moment as a priest. It's so powerful. The divine power and love in those words as Jesus makes his body and his blood present again. And it really is the very body and blood that Jesus poured out on Calvary for us. The letter to the Hebrews says that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. There's one Jesus, the same Jesus who's at the right hand of the Father is the same Jesus who gives us his own body and blood on the altar. What St. John Paul II said about the Eucharist, he said, it's the sacrament of the bridegroom and the bride. Jesus says, "I'm the bridegroom." And he continues to give himself fully to his bride, the church. And so when we come to Mass, we come to give ourselves fully to Jesus as he pours his life out for us. St. John Paul II said this, "When you come to the Eucharist, confidently open your most intimate aspirations to the love of Christ who waits for you in the Eucharist. You will receive the answer to all your worries, and you will see with joy that the consistency of your life, which he asks of you, is the door to fulfill the noblest dreams." So the consistency of life, which Jesus asks you for when he says, "Come, follow me." And when you come up to receive Holy Communion, the priest will say, or the minister will say, "The body of Christ." And we say, "Amen." And that means, "Yes, I believe." That's the bride saying to the bridegroom, "I do." So why come to Mass? Come because God is calling you to come and give your life to him fully as he gives his life fully to you. And you get caught up in that incredible rhythm of divine love of the lover, God, and the beloved, the bride, the church. And your life is transformed again and again by grace, which is God's divine love poured into you. If you're wondering, like, the body and blood of Christ, just Google Eucharistic miracles. There's been tons of them around the world that show that it's really the body and really the blood of Jesus Christ. So come to Papa's house. Come, listen to the great story of your salvation. Feast on the meal of divine love, our Savior who pours himself out for each of us. You are loved. God wants to give you everything he has in store for you. So come on to church. Come to the mountaintop.